Dr. A. Subramanian, Principal and Head of the Department of Mathematics, to inaugurate the program and welcome you all. Sir, please.
Have a nice day. Good morning. Good morning to all the members present here. On behalf of our college management, myself, teaching, non-teaching staff and students, research scholars, my hearty welcome to Dr. Panjatcharam Mariappan, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics of Indian Institute of Technology, Tirupati, Andhra Pradesh. Hearty welcome, sir. This webinar is jointly organized by the PG and Research Department of Mathematics of our college and IQAC. Today's topic is One Day National Webinar on Mathematical Modeling for Cancer Treatment. This topic is a different one. Hearty welcome to Dr. Mr. G. Bedanasamy, Principal in Charge. In the COVID-19 pandemic situation, Dr. P. Namashivayam, convener, and Dr. M. P. Sayyed Ali Nishaya, Organizing Secretary, Assistant Professor, PG and Research Department of Mathematics of our college, has taken earnest efforts to organize this one-day webinar on today, 15/8/2020, an Independence Day. Hearty congratulations and welcome to Dr. P. Namashivayam and Dr. M. P. Sayyed Ali Nishaya, Department of Mathematics of our college. Welcome, sir. Welcome, madam. Also, my best wishes and welcome to the organizing committee members, Dr. S. Chellaya, Associate Professor, Dr. N. Meena, Dr. K. Das, Dr. K. Murugan, Dr. K. Ali, Dr. S. Logambal, research scholars, students and participants from various institutions and our college. My sincere welcome to all the staff members and the students of our college who are directly or indirectly involved for the preparatory work of this national level webinar. My hearty welcome to Dr. K. Balasubramanian, IQAC coordinator, and Mr. Subhash Chandra Bose for their technical support. Once again, my hearty welcome to one and all. After completing this webinar, participants are asked to raise any type of questions related to cancer treatment or type in a chat box. Dr. Panjatcharam Mariappan, a resource person, will explain for your questions. Thank you. Thank you very much for given the opportunity. Thank you.
Thank
you, sir. Now I hand over the session to Mr. G. Bedanasamy.
Sir.
Thank you, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
Start
one. Shall we pass on to next one?
Shall we pass on to next
one?
Sir?
Bedanasamy?
Sir? Shall we pass on?
Call pannunga.
Sir?
Sir, pass on next one. Shall we pass on next one? Appellants Commissioner not available.
Patelaswamy sir,
please.
Dr. Bedana, Mr. Bedanaswamy, can you hear? Are you able to hear my voice? Bedanaswamy?
Hello?
Bedanaswamy.
Kekuda?
Kekuda, deliver your felicitation address.
Okay. Good morning to all, sir. Good morning to all.
Good morning.
It is my pleasure to wish all the participants for this national webinar titled Mathematical Modeling for Cancer Treatment. My heartfelt wishes to resource person Dr. Panjacharam Mariappan, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Indian Institute of Technology, Tirupati, Andhra Pradesh, to share his knowledge and vast experience with the student community. This program is completely conducted on a digital platform in line with social distancing norms due to COVID-19 pandemic. Also, my best wishes to IKAC coordinator Dr. K. Balasubramanian, heads of the various department, faculty members, non-teaching staff members. I also wish to our principal and head Dr. A. Subramaniam, Department of Mathematics, convener Dr. P. Namaswayam, Organizing Secretary Dr. M.P. Sayyed Ali Nisaya, and Organizing Committee members for taking effort and conducting this program. My special wishes to all distinguished invitees present through online accepting our invitation. On behalf of our college committee members, I pray God to success this webinar. Thank you, sir. Sir? Hello?
Thank you, sir. May I invite Dr. P. Namaswayam, Associate Professor and Convener of this program, to introduce the resource person. Sir, please.
Thank you, madam. Good morning, all of you. It gives me immense pleasure to introduce the resource person of the day, the young and energetic speaker, Dr. Panjacharam Mariappan, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, Indian Institute of Technology, Tirupati. He had a lot of work and research experience in Swaysya College, Salem, TV, Germany, Software Development Engineer, UMA Engineering Services in Ireland, and presently in IIT, Tirupati. He did many projects in various organizations. He has organized 4 workshops and summer schools so far. He delivered keynote address to promote mathematics in SAR countries in Kathmandu University, Nepal. He is a reviewer of the journals like Applied Mathematics and Computation, International Journal for Numerical Methods in Biomedical Engineering, Journal of Nepal Mathematical Society. So we have such an eminent personality in our midst today, Dr. Banjarsiram Mariappan. He is delivering a talk on mathematical modeling for cancer treatment in this one-day national webinar organized by the PGR Research Department of Mathematics and the Internal Quality Assurance Center of the University of Tamil Nadu. This topic is focused on applications of mathematics in real life. Now I welcome Dr. Banjarsiram Mariappan to proceed the session. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for the MDT Hindu College for organizing this one-day webinar national level. And first of all, happy Independence Day to everyone. So I think I can start my presentation straight away. Could you see my screen? Could you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Very okay. Clear.
Okay, fine. Yeah, it is very clear. I didn't put anything. Okay, I just start with plan presentation always. Okay, so let's start. I almost I have given this lecture to many places. So this is a repetitive lecture for me. So you can see some of these contents. Almost most of the contents in YouTube also. Okay. So let me start with a simple game, okay? This game is that you have to draw a house on a paper, okay? So if it is like a regular seminar, I used to give some 2 minutes time to draw, but since it is a webinar, I can't give that, and I can't see like what I am going to draw. So, but still you can attempt to draw a house on a paper, okay? I hope you will draw a house like this. First, you will draw a rectangle, and then you will put a triangle up, then you will put some door, okay? And then you will put some circle, then like this, okay? So I have given like this, almost this talk 10 to, at least 7 to 10 colleges. So most of the places, 90% of the people have drawn a house like this, okay? So they have drawn a house like this. Even if you go to any of the websites in, where you can see like home button, something like this, you can see a picture like this, okay? If you see home button, it'll be like this. Then and my next question is, are you living in a house like this, okay? How many of your houses are like this? Then the next answer which I receive is only 10 people used to raise their hands, okay? Then I ask why you when you are not living in a house, why you draw a house like that? So the answer used to be like they don't, because they are practiced to that since childhood to draw a house like this. If you ask to draw a house, they used to draw a house like this. So that is the thing. Okay. So keep this in mind. We'll come to this a little later. Okay. Another game. Okay. This is a rapid fire round quiz. Okay. So the question is, what is this one? Okay. So immediately people used to say this is length into breadth. So area. So what is this? What does it represent? So immediately they used to say it is a rectangle, okay, area of the rectangle. So then I used to ask the question, what is this one? So most of the people used to say it is weight equal to mass into gravity, okay? So mass times gravity they used to say. If I ask F equal to ma, then immediately they used to say force equal to mass into acceleration, which is Newton's second law. Then Y equal to mx. Most of the people, since it is mathematics, so most people will say this is a straight line. Okay, what does it represent? Equation of a straight line, they used to say. Then I used to ask this question, what is z equal to xy? Then there won't be some noises, but no concrete answers will be there. Okay, even there is no concrete answer. This is complete silence will be there. So they won't answer perfectly. So this is a picture, hyperbolic parabola. Okay. Okay, now let's go to the next one. So then I just increase a little bit complexity. So a equal to pi r square, immediately they will say it is a circle, area of a circle, okay? Then e equal to mc square, then they used to say Einstein equation. Then if I ask y equal to x square, they used to say it is a parabola. Okay, equation of parabola. Then this question, is it equal to xy square? Again, there won't be any answer. Okay. So this is a curve like this. Okay. It has no name for that, but there is a curve like this. Okay. Fine. Then little more complexity. So I used to ask like a square plus b square equals c square. So some people will say something, but most of the people used to say like it is a Pythagoras theorem. Okay, Pythagoras theorem they used to say. So immediately they will not say, but if I put some right angle triangle, they say it's a Pythagoras theorem. Then I used to ask this question. They used to say x square plus y square equal to r square. Immediately they will say this is a circle equation. Then this question, mostly they will not answer the question. This is some 3D equation, okay? Some 3D equation they will say, but they will not answer what is it. It's a conic equation, okay? Then next question, I used to ask this one. Then pin drop silence should be there. No one will answer anything, okay? It will be a pin drop silence. But you know what does this equation represent? It's a cart, okay? Cart in three dimensional, cart equation, okay? Now, the question is that, see, O equal to mx, A equal to lb, F equal to ma, W equal to mg, Z equal to xy. So, in all these cases, you can see that there are two numbers, okay? M is some number, X is some number, and Y is equal to mx. So, you are multiplying two numbers and you are getting something. And A equal to lb, again, you are doing the same thing. Two numbers are there, you are multiplying and you are getting some product and then you are getting. Now, the question is, why one represents straight line equation, another one represents area, another one represents another one we name it as Newton's second law and some other equations we need. Okay, three numbers only. Okay, there are two numbers and we are getting some output. Okay, so in general you are dealing with some three numbers. M is some number, X is some number, and Y is some number. You are getting as an output. Similarly here, okay, A is some number, X is some number. You are squaring it, so Y equal to X square. Once again, it is some three numbers. You are doing some manipulation and you are getting this. But still the equations are different. You say like one is parabola, another is area of circle, another is Einstein equation, etc. Same case here, okay? Three numbers are there. X is one number, Y is number, Z is number, but still the equations are there. Then I ask the question, why is it? Okay? Why each one represent different things? Okay? So, the answer is that, see, all these things, for example, Y equal to MX are A equal to LB, F equal to MA, there are some limitations also there. Okay, so not only that, see, suppose Y equal to MX, in this case, it is going to, X is going to be minus infinity to plus infinity because it is a straight line. I don't have any bound on that. I can go from minus infinity to infinity plus infinity, so it is going to be a straight line. Okay, whereas A equal to LB, I can't take that. It is a finite quantity. Okay, similarly for F equal to MA and Z equal to XY, again, you can take minus infinity to infinity plus infinity, depending on the things. Same thing here, okay, it's for all these equations. So in mathematics, all these things together, okay, I can just simply write f of x comma y comma z equal to 0, okay, a function of three variables maximum, okay. I can write it as f of x comma y comma z equal to 0. So if some of the things I can assume constant, some of the things I can keep it as a variable. So I will get the same thing. So Kendry Panker has correctly pointed out, spelled out that mathematics is the art of giving the same name to different things. Okay, so with this introduction, I will just start. Okay. Okay. So mathematical modeling for cancer treatment and COVID-19. Okay, I'll just give COVID-19 if time is permitting. Okay, otherwise I'll just use this one. So in the beginning of the lecture, I asked you to draw a house, right? So that house is okay to some sense. Okay, so in the paper, it is fine. But if I just want to live in that house, definitely I can't live. Okay, that is not perfect for me. And almost for everyone. So the thing is that if you give that drawing to a civil engineer, definitely will not agree that it's a house because he will ask some questions. There is the some of the properties which he may understand. Okay, that he will ask. If you give it to some of the people like the authorized people like Tahsildar or whoever is authorizing, for example, in Tripathi, there is something called TDMA. So that is the approval process, or CDMA in Chennai. OK, Okay, so they are giving some construction development management. So they give some kind of approval. If you give that, they will not agree that, because they will ask the question, maybe where is the path you have given for the common places to roam? Okay, where is the road, etc., etc. Questions will be there. So it's not that it's okay for some sense. Okay, some of the questions you can answer, but some of the questions you cannot answer. Let's come to this topic now. So before I'm going to the cancer treatment, I'll just see like what is mathematical modeling first. Okay, we'll understand what is mathematical modeling. Then we will go to what is the mathematical modeling for cancer treatment. So some of the slides, like almost like 20 slides, it will be covering this book. The book is Mathematical Modeling and Simulation, Introduction for Scientists and Engineers. Okay, it's a book. Okay, so Kai Valentine. So you can see that. So basic things you can see. So let's start. So first, again, I'll start with simple thing. So suppose there is a table in your home. Okay, that is shaking. Okay, that leg is a little bit problem. So it is shaking. So what you will do is you will just adjust that with some kind of wooden pieces or some pieces so that it will become like stable. It is not going to move. Okay. Now suppose you are going in a highway on a car. Okay, or a bike. Suddenly the car stops, okay, or the bike stops. It's then it starts starting. Then what we will check immediately? So most of the people used to answer that they will check the fuel tank. Okay, if it is fine, then they will check for the battery. But is that simple? Only having fuel tank and battery, not right. But still, we used to think okay, whether the battery is full or the tank is full, like that. Similarly, if you have some headache, okay, so most of the people immediately will go for simply putting some paracetamol or anacin or some kind of tablets which they know, okay, or some kind of medicines which they know. But our body is not that simple, okay, it's very complicated. There are so many parts are there inside, and we don't know like what parts are causing trouble and that produces headache. If you go to some doctors like eye doctor, eye specialist, okay, he will say that you got ear specs or something. So different people will give different opinions. And there are some websites called WebMD. So if you put headache, then it will list all kinds of disease, from fever to cancer also it will say. Okay, all kinds of diseases. But our body is not that simple, but still we used to think that simple paracetamol or anacin is fine for us to kill. Okay. So this is the problem. So how complex a car is, how complex our body or brain is, but still we think that this will cure us, okay? Scientists and engineers think the same way, okay? Initially, they will think the same way. So what they used to do is they break up the complexity of the system into simplified description of the system. So the system will be very complicated, but they will just simplify the description to understand the question, okay? So what is a model is that to an observer B, okay, an object A star is a model of an object A. So there will be an object A. For that, the key will generate a model A star, okay, to the extent that B can use A star to answer the question that interests him about it. Let's explain that in detail, okay. For example, let's take the car, okay. Car is nothing but my real problem, okay. Car is the real object for me. Now, I have to model that, okay. So what I have to do is that I have to model that. So my model is that I have to model like battery and fuel. The battery, my answer question is that whether I have battery is full or fuel tank is full. Okay, these are the two questions which I ask. So for me, an observer, the object is nothing but the B is nothing but the driver. Okay, A is nothing but the car. Car is the object. A star is nothing but this simple thing. So it's the same thing. So since I asked you to draw the house, they have drawn a house which is very simple. So that is nothing but a model, simple model, very, very simple model, which can answer some of the questions, which cannot answer many of the questions. Okay. So very, very simple model. So in this case, this is very simple model. Okay. Battery, tank, fuel. So a rectangular box with battery and fuel. This is going to give me the solution. Okay. Whether I can just identify whether the fuel tank is full or the battery is full. This, if I can identify, then I'm going to give the answers to that. Okay. I'm just trying to. And also I have drawn some simple tires and other things that also I don't require in this case, because my question is whether the battery tank is full or fuel tank, the battery is full or fuel tank is full. I don't need to worry about whether my tire is punctured or pressure is there, etc. Okay. So the best model is the simplest model. Okay. If you want to draw a best model, that should be a simplest model. that still serves its purpose. Means it has to answer the question which you raised. If it is answering the question, then that is the best model. Okay, which is still complex enough to help us to understand the system and to solve problems. Okay, that is. So now, what is the aims and teleological nature? So which is nothing but what is the motive of that? So which we are trying to see. So the main purpose of modeling and simulation is governed by its purpose of problem solving. So you have some problem, okay? Either it is a real problem or simple problem, whatever it is. So you have some problem. For that problem, your purpose is that you have to model that and then you have to simulate it. Let's see what is simulation in the moment. So that should be governed by the purpose of problem solving that we have to see. So first, what you need to identify is that you have to identify, okay, the definition means what is the problem you are going to solve. Okay, what is the problem definition to be solved for? Then you have to see what is the question to be answered. So if you answer the correct question, the correct answer will come. Okay, if you ask the wrong question, definitely the wrong answer is going to be wrong. So you got to ask the correct question so that the answer will be, you are going to get the answer in a precise way. So then you got to develop the system according to that. So system definition for which the answer is required. Then what you need to do is you got to do the system analysis. So means, so for example, in the car problem, what I have is I have to identify the parts. So the identification of the parts is nothing but for me, the question is whether the tank is full or the battery is full. So in that case, my identification of part is nothing but the car the battery and car, fuel tank. So that is nothing but the identification of the parts. So depending on the parameters, depending on the problem, it will change. Then what you need to do is you have to develop the model of the system that results to the system analysis. Okay. So now what is system? System is nothing but a collection of objects, okay, or an object or a collection of objects. We want to study the properties of that object. Okay, for example, in the car problem, we want to study the properties of that car tank, fuel tank, and the battery. So these two we are going to study. So in my system, the system is very simple, only car, battery, and fuel tank. That's it. For example, if you see that house problem, they have drawn some small things. So that is nothing but their property. So the question is not clear there. So they have drawn like that. Okay, so simple. Then what we need to do is you have to identify the simulation. Okay, simulation is nothing but you have to apply that model to answer some of the questions. Okay, you have to derive some strategy. You have to derive some kind of strategy to solve the problem. So you have given that question. So for that question, you have to develop some kind of strategy to solve the problem. For example, the simulation for the car starting problem is that you can just go and then check whether the battery is full or not, or the tank is full or not. So there are two strategies. First, you check the battery is full or not. Then you check tank is full or not. So these are two strategies which you are trying to solve. So that is going to, if you, it can give the answer or it may not give the answer because the system may be complicated. Okay. So if it is answering the question, then you are done. Okay. You have done the validation. You can apply that to the real problem. You can apply that to the real problem and then you can solve the problem. That's it. The problem is solved. If it is not solving, you have to go for the next iteration. Okay. So what does it mean is that simulation is nothing but a step application of a model with objective. Okay. You have some objective. So your problem is you got to solve the problem. For that, you got to develop some objective. Okay. For which are the question which you have asked. For that, you have to try to answer the question. For which you have to derive some strategies. So what are the strategies you follow to solve the problem? So for example, in this case, as I said, so system is car, system analysis identifying battery and fuel levels. Modeling is nothing but we just see like we are developing a car, battery and fuel tank. Okay, that is nothing but simulation is nothing but you check whether the battery and fuel level is full or not. So validation is if it is so you just find some answers to that. So checking the battery is going to solve the problem or checking the fuel level is going to solve the problem. That is your strategy. Then you are going to apply that to the real car. If it is done, then it is done. Okay, your problem is done. Okay, so means you are validated. If you refill that tank or battery, that is your strategy. You are doing that, then you are starting the car. Your problem is solved. If it is not solving the problem, then you go to go for the next level. Okay. So what are the steps involved? So when you are, so this is very simple one, but when you go for the complicated things, what we need to do is you have to do some kind of system analysis. So that things may be done earlier. Okay, already some of the problem, some of the things might be solved by some other people. So what you need to do is you have to do the literature first. Okay, some people might have done experienced the same problem earlier. So you have to check the literature. They might have documented. So you have to check the literature. Then you will get benefit from the other experiences. Then you can arrange the discussions. So some of the problems you cannot solve it completely on yourself. For example, you take the medicines for some headache problems, so that may not be solved by you. What you need to do is you go to the doctor, and then you go to get the consultation, and you go discuss with various disciplined people so that you will get some kind of idea like what is your system is functioning. So that is nothing but the discussions, meetings, and consultation, etc. you are going to do. Now what we need to do is you got to some new data you may need to generate, or you got to do some experiments so that you can improve the model or you can improve the system. Then modeling and simulation. So then what you need to do is once you develop the modeling, you can go for the mathematical model. Okay, for example, in the car battery, you see like how to develop the mathematical model and cancer treatment also. So then you have to use the appropriate software or some tools which you can use it to solve the mathematical model or some standardized tool, etc. Then validation, what you need to do is you have done some validation using your mathematical model or model which you have developed, that you have to apply to the problem and then you have to solve. Then you can go for the quantitative and qualitative analysis, like how to fit that model, etc. You can solve the problem. Then what we have is there are two, depending on the model, there are two types. One is conceptual model and another is physical model. So the conceptual model is nothing but car drawn on a paper or house drawn on a paper. So that has no physical reality. You can't live in a house, okay? So, but all life problem is solving, okay? All life is a problem solving. So conceptual model is important tool to solve the problem. You can't solve that without that conceptual model. You got to concept that and then you got to create that. From that, you will just make a real model. Okay, the physical model, you are just giving a life to the conceptual model, whatever you have created. Then you are giving a life to that and you are making it to a physical thing. So that is nothing but, for example, in the car drawn on paper, you are just giving some simplified version of the engine. Okay, and few parts of the engine connected to the fuel tank, etc. These are all kind of physical models which you are trying to do. And then you are relating to the real idea. Okay, now these are all the standard things, modeling. Now let's go for the mathematical modeling. How do we develop into a mathematical model? Why mathematics? Because mathematics is a natural language of natural language modeling. Okay, natural language modeling. So then what we need to do is you have to identify list of input parameters involved in the system. So first of all, what you need to do is you have to identify the list of input parameters. For example, in the car problem, you have to identify car tank, fuel level and battery level. That is nothing but my input parameters. Then you have to identify what is the output parameter. So list of output parameters also you have to identify. Then mathematical model is going to give you a relation between the input and output, okay, and the technology which you are going to develop. So what you need to do is you have to collect using different experiments. What you need to do is you have to get the collection of experiment using that. You have to collect the collection of input, collection of output, etc. Then you are trying to see what is the relation between them. Okay, so there may be some relations which is held, which we need to identify. Okay, it can be simple one, y equal to f of x. Okay, x is nothing but some input that is driven by some function. Then you will get some y. It may be complicated, like you will have many variables. Okay, then correspondingly we get the many output parameters also. So what is the initial study? What we need to do is, whenever you start the problem is completely black box. Okay, what is black box means? You don't know anything about it. Okay, nothing. You don't know anything about it. For example, we can say the COVID-19 situation. In the pandemic situation, when the coronavirus came, it's completely black box because we don't know anything about that. Okay, so even the WHO, the World Health Organization, doesn't know anything about that. So that's why they have given different statements on different things. Because they have uncertainty. This is completely black box because they don't know how the virus is behaving, how it is going to behave, etc. Nothing known. So they don't know anything. So that is the complete black box. That's why it spread. Then they came to know that it is spreading from person to person, etc. So that comes to some of the level of understanding. So that means immediately it is like once the problem is posted, it is completely black box because you don't know anything about it. There will be uncertainty. Then what we used to do is there will be some experiments will be done. So based on that, there will be some hypothesis they will be posting. That hypothesis may be true or may not be true. Okay, that hypothesis you got to validate. So this is kind of question and answer game. So there will be some question will be posted. For example, the COVID-19 case also, they were testing many things. So they were testing some medicines and then they were answering whether it is solving or not. So this is kind of question and answer game. So this is nothing but the modeling is going to do the same. So what we are doing in mathematical model is a triplet. So what we need is you need a system first, okay? And then you need a question related to system. So you develop a system. For that system, you need a question, Okay, that is question. Then you have to develop a mathematical statement, set of statement which is related to that system at which you have to develop. So set up mathematical system which can be answered to Q. Okay, which can be used to answer Q. So then what you need to do is you have to identify the list of decision variables. So what are the variables which is going to make the decisions for them? Okay, so that you have to identify. Then you have to collect all the input variables, output variable, and there will be something like state variables will be there, and exo and endogenous variable are in mathematical time we can say independent or dependent variable. Okay, I hope the linear algebra courses you might have cleared up this one, dependent and independent variables. So these are all there. Then you have some random variables as you have seen in the probability courses, etc. Okay, so this is nothing but the system. So the state variable, so what you need to do is, so that mathematical quantities or the mathematical statement which you have written, that will be involving some kind of variables. Okay, you develop something, so that will be involving some kind of variable that is going to describe the system. So that S1, S2, Sn, that is called a state variables. Okay, that is going to answer the question which we are posting. But it is not necessary that all the variables would be answered. Okay, you can just make it as a reduced problem also. Okay, so what you can do is, for example, there will be, for a system, there will be many more variables will be there. Many more variables will be there. For example, if you take the car problem, you can take the fuel tank level, you can take the car battery level, you can take the air pressure in the tire, or you can see like what is the ventilation inside that, or you can check many other parameters in the car. These are all variables for the car, but you don't need to consider all the things for your problem, because your question is that whether the car tank is full or not, or battery is full or not. Only two questions you have. Okay, in that case, you don't need to worry about whether the air pressure is there in the tire, or the tire is punctured or not, or your ventilation is there or not. These are all not required. So my problem is reduced now. Okay, some variables I am going to reduce. So that is going to describe again. So if you reduce that is called reduced system. Okay, you don't need to worry about all the variables. You can just reduce the system. That is called reduced system. So as I said, this is a question and answer game. So it will have a real world problem. You will have a system. For that system, you have a question. So for that question, you have a model. Okay, that model you have developed like SQM. Then you will formulate a mathematical problem. From that mathematical problem, you will answer the question. Okay, that is going to answer the mathematical problem question. That problem A star is answered, the question Q star is answered by A star. Okay, then we check whether the A is going to answer that. If A is already answered, then we are done. If it is not done, what you got to do is you got to go through the cycle again. You got to improve your system, or you got to ask the question differently, or you got to ask the question correctly, and then you got to go for the mathematical problem. Then once again, you go for the cycling. Okay, this is the thing. Then based on the philosophy, categories into different things, so phenomenological model and mechanistic model, and based on the system also they develop into different things like physical and conceptual, natural and technical, stochastic, deterministic, etc. Similarly, based on the question also there are different questions are there, direct and inverse problem, etc. Mathematical statements also, because different things like linear, non-linear, analytical solution, numerical, etc., etc. Okay, so this is how the mathematical concepts are developing. So most of the time, the problem will be like a black box problem. Okay, once the question is posted, it will be black box problem. Then we'll slowly move to the gray box, means you will understand something. For example, the COVID-19 situation, it was completely black box in the January month. Now we are in the gray box level. Once we develop everything, so we'll almost move to the white box. Once the vaccine, everything is done, then almost we'll move to the white box situation. So this is kind of things, okay? So we'll be moving from one place to another place. So most of the societal problems, like how the societal system is functioning, those are a kind of black box problem, because a simple Facebook post or something can create a riots and then kill people. So like it happened in Bangalore or something, okay? So these are kind of societal problem, which is completely black box. Means you don't know anything about that. If you just put some kind of Facebook post also, it will just create some problem. Whereas gray box problem, you will just understand something. So if you put this one, then you can just say like, this is going to happen. For example, you can just understand that if you eat some of the hazardous things, you will understand that you will get some kind of food poison, etc. So these are kind of gray box problems. So you will understand some of the things, but you don't know the certainty. So there will be some uncertainty. Whereas white box problem, if you give this input, then definitely this will be the output. That we will know definitely. So that is kind of white box problem. So in black box, you don't know any information, whereas in the white box problem, you'll know all the information. Okay, so this I have mentioned as a warning. That's why I have given it, kept it in the red color box with the yellow text. Okay, so don't believe that the model. So you have so by keeping in the mind, you have developed something. Don't believe that the model is reality. Okay, it may not replicate the reality. It may replicate something else. Okay, so don't believe that the model whatever you have developed is reality. Maybe wrong. So you have to check that. And don't extrapolate the region of it. So this is kind of the problem where it used to happen in the black box problem. For example, if you see that cases like the societal problem, so some society may have some kind of situation which they will find, but what they will do is they will extrapolate them. For example, I will give a simple example. You may have some headache, okay? So for that headache, you might have used a medicine called paracetamol or anacin or whatever you use. But someone else may have the same thing. So in that case, will they? So what we can ask is, we can't suggest the same medicine because the medicine may not be fit for him. Whatever it was cured for you may not cure for him. Because for him, the headache may be due to different reason. So that means you are extrapolating whatever it is solving you, it is solving for him or her. So that is not going to happen. Okay, so don't extrapolate the region of it. So you have developed a model and then you have solved the system, it's not going to fit for other one. Okay, so that is the thing. And don't distort reality to fit the model. So this is happening in most of the societal problem. So when there are, so if you see some of the kind of things like honor killing, etc. So that happens because they don't, because they are not fitting into the model which the society has developed. So in that case, what they are trying to do is they are trying to fit him into that, fit him or her to that model. If he's not fitting that, then what they are doing is he's cutting them or killing them, etc. That is called corner killing. So those kind of things are kind of distorting the reality to fit the model. Okay, because they are not fitting to the model, so they are killing them. So these are kind of things. Okay, then don't retain the discredited model. Means your model may be discredited because you can see that these three and four are maybe like contradicting each other, but these are things like, okay, so that should be careful. So don't retain a discredited model. So your model may be working for some situation, but it may not be credited. Okay, it has to be accepted by the scientific community, etc. So that means don't retain a discredited model. And last but not the least, okay, don't fall in love with your model. Okay, since you develop the model, it doesn't mean that model is the universal solution. Okay, so don't fall in love with your model at any time. So these are things. Okay, now let us come for the BioHeat equation for cancer treatment. So this was the work which I did in Ireland. Okay, it was a project with many universities, which is so little later. It is published in the Nature Scientific Reports paper. So my talk is based on these two papers. Okay, I'll just show you that. Okay. So let's come to that cancer, second part of our webinar. So that is cancer treatment. So what we have is like due to liquor drinking and other smoking, etc. There are many cancers which is occurring. Okay, mostly the liver cancer. So 23, it is in this paper, it is predicted that 23 million people will be affected by cancer by 2013 Europe. Okay, so most HCC, which is hepatocarcinoma cancer, okay, that is most common liver cancer. Okay, which is liver cancer, which is happening due to liquor drinking and smoking. So if that cancer occurred, what is the standard therapy is that they will go for the best therapy is that you have to change the liver completely, transplantation liver. Okay. The next one is surgical treatment. So the surgical treatment is like it is suitable for 70. What happened is that it is not suitable for 75 to 95% of the cases. It is not suitable because the cancer will be in complicated position, so they can't do that surgical treatment. But the best treatment is transplantation, but inadequate donors. Maybe you will not get the donors properly. So that also is difficult. So then what will they do is they will go for the bridging therapy. So the bridging therapy, what does it do is it will limit the cancer growth for some time, okay, until the donor is available or sometimes it can cure also. So they will limit the cancer growth. So there are different types of treatments are there. So that is called, these are called minimally invasive cancer treatment. Means it is going to kill the minimum amount of cancer cells, okay? Not all the complete liver. It is going to kill minimal amount of cancer cells. So in minimal invasive cancer treatment, so there are different types of treatment called radio frequency ablation, cryo ablation, okay, microwave ablation, laser ablation, and ultrasonic ablation, and irreversible electroporation. So in all these cases, almost we are playing some kind of kit, a kit which we are playing. So in radio frequency ablation, we will put some kind of kit. Whereas in cryo ablation, we will cool, we will do the cooling, okay, then dispar the kidney cancer, etc. And microwave ablation, we will do something. Okay. So,
okay.
So this is a minimal invasive cancer treatment. What will happen is, see, there is a under treatment and over treatment. What will happen is, see, recurrent, this is, this would be treated by a well-experienced doctor. But the problem is that there are not, they are called as, oncologist, okay, radiologist or oncologist. So they used to do this treatment, but the problem is there are not enough number of oncologists or radiologists. So there will be some inexperienced doctors will be there. So in this case, what will happen is if they are doing the under treatment, so they have to give the correct amount of optimal amount of heat should be produced in the cells, okay, in the liver, so that cancer cells will be dead. But what happened is that if the doctor is inexperienced, he may go for under treatment. If it is under treatment, after some days, after some months, the tumor will reoccur. Okay, that is called recurrence of tumor. Or if they are also over treatment, unnecessarily if they give more cells, what will happen is it will lead to death immediately. Okay, so these are two complications are there. So means it is requiring a more experienced interventional radiologist. And this is the local regional treatment which is using the RFID. I will just show you the video. So how does this treatment works? Okay, so it works in this way. So you have a liver and you have a tumor over there. Okay, so what they will do is they have images. They will collect the images, CT scan images or MRI scan images or ultrasonic images. They will collect it. So from that images, okay, they will place that patient, for example, in the CT bed. They will keep it, and then they will keep some pad on the thigh, and then they will just get the images, okay? They will get the images. For example, these are the images they are getting. They identified two tumors over here. So they located the tumor. Now they will insert the needle, okay? That needle is inserted. When the needle is inserted, it's going to produce some kind of heat. So that heat is going to be killing the tumor. Okay, this is going to kill the tumor. So it is going to produce heat now. So it is producing the heat and then it is killing the tumor. Okay, then they will just retract the needle. They will retract the needle and then they will just go to next one. So they will go for the next one now. Okay, yeah, so now. So by keeping in mind that you have a mathematical model which we have done. Now the question is, what is the system for us? Okay, our system is nothing but, these are all our collection of system. Okay, for cancer treatment, these are all our system, we'll see. Okay, I will explain a little more. So you have a needle here, okay, you have a needle here. In the clinical environment, they just insert the needle here, it is inserting the needle, and in the CT scan images, they are collecting the needle. And then they have to develop the topological model from this. Okay, the image processing they will do, and then they will develop a topological model. And what they need to do is they have to imitate whatever they have done using the mathematical things. Okay, using mathematical things, they have to imitate. So what are the inputs they have is they have something like the heat is produced by this generator, needle, the RFA generator we used to call it as. Okay, this is generating the heat, and you can see the heat curve. Okay, the temperature curve it is producing, the temperature curve you can see. How much power they are giving, etc. It has many thermocouples, means how much temperature is given at different location, that is measured here. So you can see like five different thermocouples, okay, that is giving the different locations the temperature distribution. And this is kind of microwave needle. And here we have something, the mathematical model. Using the mathematical model, we solved it and then simulate the problem. Now, depending on the problem, depending on the size of the tumor also, it varies. For example, if there's tumor size is very small, you have to go for the 2 cm ablation. If the tumor size is little big, you have to go for the 3 cm ablation. And depending on that tumor size also, you have different times also, like 15 minutes, 30 minutes, etc., 10 minutes, etc. So depending on that, it will be going. So this is the needles. Okay, in the needle, what you have is, you have a big needle. It has an insulated stainless steel. It is a conducting part. Okay, this is a conducting stainless steel broker. Okay, it is there. So this is the only conducting part. Okay, these are all insulated, and this is a retractor part. So you can remove and then you can. So these are the needle which is going to produce the heat. Needle location which is going to produce the heat. So as I said, depending on the tumor size, you can just move the needle size. So there is a push over here. So if you push it, it will, this needle will come out. If it is a 2 cm, means it is going to kill the tumor of size diameter 2. Okay, so this is going to make a 2 cm heating. So the diameter will be almost 2. Okay, 2 cm, you can make it diameter 2. Similarly, 3 cm. So you can just measure the size of the tumor, and then you can say, like, if the tumor is within fitting inside a sphere of radius or diameter 3 or 4, you can put in this. Okay, this is the image here. So we have done the mathematical model. Now what is the system? So the system is our entire body, okay, and the clinical environment of the artery. Question number one, okay, because we are going to develop the model. So we got, what we need to do, we got to identify the system, we got to identify the question, then we got to develop the mathematical model. Question number one, can we create a simple model for RFA treatment? That is the question number one. So in that, we have sub questions, okay. First question, can we create a liver vessel tumor model, okay. Then second question, can it produce the same power produced by the needle? Which means the doctors are using that needle in the clinical environment, using different powers, they are producing the heat and etc. And the power is produced by the generator, etc. So can we produce the same power produced by the generator, the needle generator, okay, needle plus generator, which one? Third question, can we implement the same protocol followed by the doctors? Because the doctors are using different, for different treatments, they are using different protocol. Depending on the size of the tumor, they are using that. Can we implement the same protocol for the doctors? Okay, that is that question. Question number two. Can we predict the temperature profile before the treatment? Okay, so keeping this mind, you have the power profile that is going to give you the heat generation, etc. So depending on that, can you predict the temperature before they are going for the treatment? So they can play around that, whether they can go for the 2 centimeter protocol or 3 centimeter protocol, or they can manage the power by increasing or decreasing, that we can play around. So for that, can we predict the temperature before the treatment? Okay. Third question, can we predict the cell death model? So means, depending on the temperature, we can say that if the temperature is above 50 degree or something, we can say that this is going to give you the prediction. Okay, the cell death, which is going to say like whether the cells are alive or dead, that you can see. So these are all the questions which we need to answer. Now, mathematical statement. So what we need to do is, we have to see how the heat is transferred from the needle to the liver. Okay, that is the mathematical statement we need to generate. Second mathematical statement, we got to develop a power generation or heat source from the needle. That we got to generate. That is the second mathematical statement we got to do. Third mathematical statement is temperature controlled power supply. Means you got the power should be controlled by the temperature. In that RFA generator, there is a beep sound will come. If the temperature is reaching high, like 105 degrees Celsius, then automatically what will happen is that power will cut off. Okay, then the corresponding couple, thermocouple, that will cut off. Okay, means that there won't be any power supply for that. So that can we develop a mathematical statement for that also. Fourth question, can we develop cell death model due to the temperature? Okay, these are the things. So I'll just little bit explain the heat transfer model only. The remaining things, maybe you can look at the paper or I will just give you the source of the paper. Okay, fine. As I said, the mathematical model is a game between the input and output. Okay, so this is a questioning answer game. So we have to see like what is the input and what is the output. So what are the input for us? CT scan images, blood fluid fusion, body temperature, protocol, and the needle location of the image and power input from the missile. So these are the input parameters. So what are the output we need to generate? We have to see what is the liver geometry, what is the tumor geometry, what is the vessel geometry, what is the needle geometry. So these are the output we need to generate using mathematical tools and topological tools. Then we got to see like what is the temperature around tumor cells. So there is a tumor cell, around that we got to see like what is the temperature. Then we got to see what is the cell state around tumor cells. So that also we got to see. Okay, so here what we need to do is, our purpose of the, this is the project. So in this project, what is our purpose is that we have to develop a software tool which is going to help for less experienced interventional radiologists to visualize the treated ablations, how the treatment is happening, that we have to visualize before the treatment or during the treatment we have to. So there are some tools available, but we are trying to develop some advanced tools, so that is the ultimate. So this was a project which we did around 45 million euros, 4.5 million euros, okay? So almost like 45 crores or something. Yeah, so here what is the project name is called Clinic Impact Project, okay? Clinical intervention modeling, planning and proof for ablation cancer treatment. It was a project with many universities. So we did work with the Fraunhofer in Germany, Fraunhofer Institute. And then clinic university. So in every country, there is a clinical partner and technical partner. So Fraunhofer is a technical partner and University of Leipzig is a clinical partner. Similarly, University of Graz is a clinical partner and Graz University is a technical partner. Here, this is a Turku hospital. Okay, that is a clinical partner and Alto University is a technical partner. And I was working in this company in Uma, which is in Ireland. And then Radboud University in Netherlands. So this is a project supported by European Union. So our objective is to develop the model. So this is the model, this is the tool which we develop, okay? So this would be useful for the RSA treatment in liver cancer, which would run as a single disease. These are some of the objectives we have. Okay, so we have something like we have to predict the lesion on the day of the treatment within the fraction of second, okay? And it should accept the patient-specific parameters. So the patient-specific parameters include, you got to see like how the blood perfusion is there, means how the blood flow is there. Because the needle is inserting in the liver, there will be some blood flow will be going on, so that we got to do. And then device-specific parameters, for example, the needle geometry, needle location, etc. These are the parameters. So this is the clinical model. Once again, okay, in the clinical model, there will be three things. So please keep this in mind, there will be three things. Diagnostic CT imaging will be there. So before the treatment, they will be taking some CT scan images. During their treatment, they will be taking some CT scan imaging. And after the treatment, they will be taking one CT scan imaging. Okay, means after 3 months or six months, 12 months, they will be observing the patient using them. So this is the clinical model where they will be taking the segmentation like arterial, portal, venous, etc. They will be taking. And this is the clinical workflow. So they'll be taking the CT scan images, collection of CT scan images. They'll be registering it in common places. And then we got to do the, using mathematical tools, what we need to do is you got to develop the three-dimensional geometry. Okay, it's a topological geometry, which you got to generate from this model. Okay, using mathematical tools, we got to develop that. And then you got to create a complicated vessel geometry, and then this tumor also. So these are all the things we call the segmentation, means where the liver is, because that if you see this geometry, it has ribs, means the bones, etc. is there, kidney, everything is there. We got to identify, because we are not concentrating on all the things, our system is only liver. Okay, so we got to segment that separately, so that is called segmentation. We are just getting only the liver segmentation. Similarly, vessels inside the liver and only the tumor inside the liver. So those are all segmented. Then these things should be kept together, which is called combined model. Then what we need to do is we are just making some kind of assumptions so that we just do like a local regional treatment. So we just make only some around the needle. We just generate a sphere of radius 6 centimeter because maximum the diameter is 5 centimeters. So we are generating a radius 6 centimeter, means the diameter is 12. So that is sufficient to, apart from that diameter, the temperature is assumed that it is negligible. Okay, it is not more. So we just generated a simple model, and then we try to solve the problems. We just insert the needle, okay? And then we get what is the proper location. From that, we get all the input parameters, and then we simulate, and we see like what is the output of them. Okay, the upper simulation, we see what is the output of them. Then these are all happening before the treatment. Okay, these are all happening before the treatment, and this is happening during the treatment. Okay, during the treatment, they will insert the needle, and then they will get the needle location. And then they will give the input to that software tool that will predict the cell death. Okay, how much cells are dead around. Then after 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, they will be observing them. Okay, this is called post-interventional. So in that case, they will again segment. Okay, what is the there will be two things. One is the model prediction, which is the green color, red color one. Okay, then they will be segmenting the real one, that is in the green curve. Then we got to validate our model in such a way that whether both are matching or not. Okay, then we have to use some statistical tool to match whether it is matching perfectly or not. And some of the topological metrics we have to use, metrics-based concepts we have to use to get what is the output of that. So in our model, these are the device-specific parameters. We have the device-specific parameters are power input, needle geometry, temperature control algorithm, treatment protocol, cooling procedure. These are all the device-specific parameters. So these are all the things, okay, device-specific parameters. Once again, the temperature profile, you have see they are giving the power. So once the power is increasing, you can see that that is increasing, okay. So between there will be drops, so you can see that there is a drop in this one also, okay. So this is the one. So this also we have to come. Okay, once you come to the liver, there is one thing is that blood perfusion. Blood perfusion means how much heat effect is lost, because once you are heating, the blood will be circulating. So due to that, there will be some loss of the heat effect, because if you just heat some boil some milk or water, if you just put some, sprinkle some cold water, automatically the temperature will calm down. Okay, the temperature will go down. So that effect will happen here. So that also we have to take into account. So those are the things which is happening here. So blood perfusion, tissue tumor test, etc. And we have to see like what is the specific heat capacity, means what is the capacity of the specific heat capacity of the, means how much it can contact, etc. These are some of the things which we use. Okay, now we'll come to the mathematical model. How do we develop the mathematical model? I would say not going to be complicated, so let's explain in a very simple one. Okay, this heat transfer is a discipline of thermal heating. So what is doing is, this heat transfer is nothing but conversion of exchange of heat between physical systems. So for example, you take a pan. In that pan, what you are trying to do is, you are just keeping some spoon. Okay, so initially there won't be any heat, but after sometimes if you just touch it, what will happen? You will experience more heat. Okay, you will just experience more heat in that. So the heat will be flowing from, you can see that the heat will be going from one place to another. We'll see where it is going. Okay, heat flow, the heat will be going from hot place to cold place. Okay, it will be just moving. Okay, it will just move to that place. So we are trying to model this one. Okay, almost the same philosophy is going in this model also. Okay, the same whatever is happening in our spoon or the things which is happening in our kitchen, the same thing is happening here. Okay, heat flow in a solid rod with circular cross section A. So let us assume very simple one. Okay, simple model we are going to take. So this is the cross section which I am going to take. What is happening is, we are saying that it is a perfectly insulated rod. Okay, perfectly insulated rod means there is no heat escapes radially, means there won't be any heat escape in the y direction here. Okay, radial direction. So it is going only in the radial direction. It's not going to happen. No heat escapes from the radial. No heat escapes radially. So the heat is going only in this direction. Okay. So heat flow only along the axis of symmetry of the rod. So it is going to happen only in this direction. So initial temperature. So initially the temperature is nothing but the room temperature. Now what happens? That needle, suddenly you are rising the temperature. So at one end, you are suddenly rising the temperature. So it is suddenly rising. So what will happen? The heat will be flowing from hot place to cold place, as it happens in our spoon or the things which is happening in our kitchen. Okay. So now what we are trying to do is, we are just taking delta x as the thickness. Okay. We are trying to do some calculus. Okay. Simple calculus thing. What we are doing to do is, we are just making a simple delta x thickness. So this is the delta x. So this weight, this is the cylinder. Okay, there is a white cylinder here. In the white cylinder, if you see the height of that is nothing but my thickness. So that thickness I am just taking, okay, that is delta x thickness of a section through the rod located at the point x. Now what we are trying to do is, what is the in this one, there is a left side and right side, left side and right side. So some of the once it is moving from left side to right side, what will happen? So left side is x, right side is x plus delta x. That will happen, some heat will be absorbed by the rod. Okay, some heat, there will be some heat loss due to the properties of the needle or properties of the rod. So some heat will be lost. So heat flow at x will not be same as heat flow at x plus delta x, because it will take some time to reach that. So you can see this spoon at the end of the which is touching near the vessel, it is hot, whereas which is touching at the end, it is very cool. So that means there will be a temperature variation. So heat flow at x is not same as heat flow at x plus delta x. But according to the conservation of energy, there is a principle in physics, okay, which says that rate of change of heat content is nothing but rate of heat conducted in and out of section. Okay, so the energy is conserved. Okay, the energy is conserved. So what we are trying to do is we are just trying to develop the model. So assume no heat production inside the rod. So we are once you are developing model, we got to assume many of the things like the car model or the cows model which we generated. We have assumed some of the things, then we generated. Same way here, we are assuming something, no heat production inside the rod or heat loss from the surface of the rod. So there is no heat production inside and outside. So there is only heat which is produced at the one layer that is transferring. It's the only thing. Now what we need to do is we have to make the function. Okay, so we have to bring the mathematical thing. So we are producing some function. Okay, the function is heat flux. What is heat flux? Heat flux is nothing but the rate of heat passing through the cross section per unit area per unit time. So there is a cross section here. What we are trying to do is what is the rate of heat passing from here to here? Okay, rate of heat passing through the cross section. This is per unit time within the time within the unit area which we are trying to do. So that is J of x comma t. Then what is the net rate? Is nothing but J of x comma t into, so this is per unit area. So this area may be different. So we are trying to find what is the net rate. So at this place and this place, what is the net rate heat? Net rate is nothing but net means we are just trying to find what is the difference between that. So J of x comma t into A minus J of x plus delta x into t into A. So A is nothing but the area. Now what we need to do, we have to identify the temperature. What is the temperature inside the rod? Okay. So that heat flux is going to give you the temperature, which we will see, very simple. Okay. So T of x comma t is going to give you the temperature. Okay. Again, the function T of x comma t denotes the temperature of the rod at position x at time t. Now what will happen? Some of the heat energy is absorbed by the rod. Okay. Once the changes in temperature at T plus delta T, so that temperature will not be same when the time is moving. Okay. It will be transferring. So what will happen? At T at x plus delta t will not be same as T at x comma t. So there will be temperature difference between the time also. So temperature difference also in this making it. Okay, that is nothing but the rate of change of heat content which we are saying. Temperature difference. T of x comma t into T of x comma t plus delta t minus T of x comma t. So that is temperature difference. So we just see that net rate is nothing but heat flux. Okay, the difference net flux. Okay, J of x comma t into A minus J of x plus delta x into T into A. Whereas rate of change of heat content on the right hand side is T of x comma t plus delta t minus T of x comma t. Now, the amount of heat required to change the temperature. So it is depending on the mass of the cross section also. So what is the mass of the cross section? Mass is nothing but density into volume. Okay, mass is density into volume. So volume is nothing but, so for this cross section, what is the volume? A is nothing but the area of this cross section and delta x is the thickness. So A into delta x. Okay, so suppose A is pi r square and delta x is the height. What is the area of the cylinder? Sorry, the volume of the cylinder, pi r square h. So that's what we are given, A into delta x. Now, rate of change of heat content, which is nothing but given by, so we have something like here, we have T of x comma t plus delta t minus T into x comma t. So here, what I'm going to use, I'm going to use some kind of the mean value theorem, which I'm going to use. So in that case, you can say T of x comma t plus delta t minus T of x comma t is going to be something like, using the mean value theorem, you can say that something f dash is going to come. So using the mean value theorem, I can use that tau t by dou theta by t, where theta is assumed some constant, okay? Something in between that x and delta x, it is going to be there, okay? So it is there. Then this is proportional to that. So it is given that it's proportional to the mass section. So I'm just proposing, I'm just multiplying that with the mass section, okay, proportional. So that is nothing but this one. And this is some proportionality constant. There will be some proportionality constant that is nothing but the specific heat. Okay, proportionality factor, which is nothing but a specific heat constant. So this is nothing but so simple with respect to, so we got something like T of x comma t plus delta t minus T of x comma t. We simply use the Lagrange mean value theorem. Okay, sorry. Mean value theorem we used, and then we have used this. Okay, fine. Now what we have is theta is nothing but x comma delta. So that I have already explained. So this one. Now what we have is this side, rate of change of heat content, we have already T. Okay. On the right hand side, we have in terms of J. Now we have to bring that J also in terms of T. So that we will get it in a single variable T. Okay. So T will be our dependent variable. Okay. Now, J of x comma delta t into A. So this we have already mentioned that both are same. So j of x comma delta t into a minus j of x comma delta x into t into a is nothing but this one. Now I'm just dividing this by delta x. Okay, then I am just allowing delta x tends to zero. Once the delta x tends to zero, this will happen. Theta and x will coincide, and this side this will become like minus tau j by tau x into, because this is a two dimensional, two variables are there, x and t is there. So here this with respect to t and here this with respect to x. Okay, so this is nothing but my partial differential equation. Okay, now we are not done, because we got to do some kind of the j also we got to bring it in terms of t that we are trying to do. So that comes from the Fourier's law. So for this, once again I just explained it in a simple way. So you have a cup of coffee. Okay, in the cup of coffee, so we are trying to model the heat flux. Okay, heat flux also we are trying to bring it in terms of temperature. You have a cup of coffee. Okay, you just have a cup and that you are drinking some cup of coffee. If you keep it in a cup of coffee, the heat will not be there for a long time. Okay, whereas if you keep the same amount of coffee or a milk on a bigger fan, you can see that the heat will be lost sooner, means the heat will be transferred sooner. So the you can see that if the in a cup of coffee, if it is cooling in 5 minutes, in the pan it may be cooling in 3 minutes or 2 minutes. Okay, now if the same amount of coffee or milk is this is a picture from Tirupati Devasthan where they are making the laddus. So if they are keeping in a bigger container, that what will happen, it will last very soon, because you are putting in a very bigger container. So that means, what does it mean, more the area is exposed or more the volume is exposed, it is going to be, the heat loss is going to be quicker. Okay, more heat will be heat transfer. So more is the area exposed, more will be the heat transfer. That means the heat flux is directly proportional to the area. The heat flux is directly proportional to the area. Okay, more is the area exposed, more will be the heat transfer. Okay, so J is directly proportional to A. Now next one, you have a cup of coffee, you have a cup, okay? Thus, there will be a temperature in your body and there will be a temperature in the cup. So there will be some temperature, so you can't hold, if it is so hot, you can't hold it. Now same cup of coffee, same cup, instead of a coffee, I'm just putting a molten iron rod, okay? Molten iron, I'm just putting in a cup. Then immediately you just leave your hand, because it will be like thousands or hundreds of degrees difference. So immediately you will break it, or you will just burn your head, hand. Okay, same thing. This is happening in our Tamil Nadu. So they used to do that. So to protect that from heat, they used to keep some neem leaves, etc. So these are some of the things. So there will be temperature difference. Okay, so why do I want to say this? So depending on the temperature, the heat transfer will be. So if there is a more temperature difference, the heat will be transferring quicker. Okay, more is the temperature difference, the heat will be transferred quickly. So temperature difference. So J is directly proportional. Heat flux is directly proportional to the temperature difference. More the temperature difference, more the heat transfer. Okay. Next one. Okay. Suppose you are in a campfire. If you are near the fire, what you will see, you are feeling more heat. Whereas if you are far from the fire, or you are near the kitchen or near the stove, if you are keeping your hand near the stove, you will feel more heat. If you are keeping away from that, you will not see more heat. So this is one place I want to stress, the mathematical model is not over predicted. Okay, so this is happening here, but you should not over predict that. For example, if you see this one sun, okay, in sun what is happening? Mercury is very near to sun, whereas Venus is little far and Earth is little far. But if you see the temperature, Mercury is having less temperature than Venus, because as I said, near the heat you will feel more heat. Okay, near the fire you will feel more heat. But Mercury is near the sun, which is a firing planet. Okay, but still it will not feel the more heat. So this is the place where you should not over predict or extrapolate your region of your model. Okay, so Mercury is feeling less heat because of its atmosphere. Okay, due to that it is doing that. Okay, so but in our model it is going to be varied. Near the heat, more the heat transfer. Okay, further from the heat, less the transfer. So that means the distance is matter. Okay, near the dx, so j is inversely proportional to dx. So j is inversely proportional. So that means what we have is j is We have J is directly proportional to A, J is directly proportional to T, temperature difference, and J is inversely proportional to distance. Okay, so J is nothing but some proportionality constant will come. So I'm putting minus K because it is moving from hot place to cold place. Okay, so J is equal to minus K dt into dx. So we got that dt into dx. So earlier we got that equation. So this is our equation. I'm just putting J is nothing but dou t by dou x. So this is going to be dou square t by dou x square. Okay, K into dou square t by dou x square. So this is the heat equation, okay, which is used for our cancer treatment. So this is one dimensional, whereas if you go for the three dimensional, immediately what we will put is, we will put this symbol delta square. Delta square is nothing but tau square t by tau x square plus tau square t by tau y square plus tau square t by tau z square. Okay, so that is nothing but our bioheat equation. So here, apart from this, what we have is, we have something like, so this is for the heat trap. Whereas once you insert in the liver, what will happen is, there will be some heat sink and heat source will be there. Because already your body is generating some heat, okay, so that is covered by this one. And then heat source is nothing but this coming from the needle, and then you have something like heat sink is there. Okay, heat sink is due to the blood flow. So these are the things. So this is the mathematical model for our cancer treatment. So tau C, rho tau T by dou T, okay, so that we have seen here, same thing. K into delta T, so this is the thermal conductivity, and we have something heat loss is due to that blood perfusion. So you can see that this is the arterial temperature, means the blood is flowing here, and this is the blood perfusion, it means how fast the blood is flowing, that is given, and this is the heat sink term, and we have a heat source term. So from that we are getting. The same way, see, if you are doing some exercise, so this you can see it in this book, nano and bioheat transfer fluid flow. The same way, what you can do is, suppose you are going walking in upstairs or lift something or doing some cycling, the same equation is covering the temperature distribution in your body. Because when you are doing some exercise or walking, you will feel some internal heat, so that you will get some sweating and other things. So that is coming due to the same equation. Okay, this is the same equation that is called metabolic rate, etc. So the same thing is coming. Okay. So in our problem, so our problem is not done. So almost I have another 5 slides to explain. So what is our problem? So what is the domain of our problem? We have the liver geometry, vessel geometry, and tumor geometry. And then we simplify that into a sphere geometry with the vessels and other things. So that is the domain of the problem. Then is the system closed? The system is not closed because you have some variables. T is there. Okay. So it is not closed because you need some more. This is a partial differential equation. Okay. So, partial differential equation is there with the time and the other things. So we need some boundary conditions, some initial conditions, etc. Okay. So you need at least three conditions. So boundary conditions is required, and then you require the initial conditions also. So the system is not closed. So in order to make the system, you have to impose some boundary conditions. What is the temperature of the boundary? What is the temperature of the boundary of the sphere? What was the initial temperature, etc. Then the question is the problem well posed? Means if you make some small changes in the input, will it affect that or not? These are some conditions. So, what are the initial conditions? What are the boundary conditions? We'll see. So, initial boundary condition is, so this is the boundary condition. This is once again from the Fourier's law, which we'll get it. Okay. And the vessel boundary, this will be the boundary condition which you are using. And on the initial condition, we initially assume that it is T equal to T0. Okay. D is nothing but T0. Okay. Then, once we find the temperature, we need to identify whether cells are alive or not. For this, simply what we can do is, see the car problem, we can just mathematically model that into two things. If the car tank is full, the fuel tank is full, you can just say that it is mathematically, you can say that it is one. If it is not full, you can say it is zero. If it is in between, it is going to be between zero and one. Now the same case here, we have the cell death in three states. One is called alive, second is called vulnerable, another is called death. So at any given point, the cells can be either alive or it is going to be vulnerable. Vulnerable means it can move from alive to dead or dead to alive. Okay, alive to dead or dead to alive. So it can move from there. So there are three states. And third one is death. So at any given point, it will be, we can just make it as a binary equation, okay, kind of binary equation. One, A plus B plus D equal to 0. So at any given point, either it will be alive, the cell will be either alive or death or vulnerable. So A plus B plus D equal to 0. What? So this is the mathematical model which we developed with Oxford University. Okay, you can see that in this paper. So in this one, we made it as a two-state model instead of because a plus b plus d equal to 1, we just make it b is equal to 1 minus a minus d. So using that, we just made it like a simple model, Seldes model, two-state model, which is the two ordinary differential equations, okay, system of ordinary differential equation with some initial conditions. So these are the things which we are using. Then once again, for the heat generator in that, we can use different models are there in the literature. One is called Joule heat model, which is coming from the Maxwell's equation, okay, one of the famous equation of this century, of the last century. So that is this one, Joule heat model. From that, you can get that, what is the heat distribution from that. Then this is the heat distribution. This is the from the power, because we need to give this some relation between the power and the heat source. So this is the heat source from that. Then what we have is we have a point source model. This is another model which we developed. Since what we observe that from the heat source model, you can see that this is following some Gaussian distribution. Okay, Gaussian distribution is following. Okay, depending on the derivatives, you can see that some fluctuations will be there. So what we model is that we just model that using the Gaussian distribution. Okay, using the Gaussian distribution, we just model that using this function. Okay, p of x. This is the point source model, which is also a heat source model, which we have model. Okay, this is second model. Then I asked the question whether can we model the power generator also. So that model is done using the integral partial differential equation. Okay, this is proportionality PID, proportionality, integral and derivative. So all these things are there. So using that, we just model that, which is called PID control. Okay, this PID control is there. We need to estimate the parameters based on the generator. So that's what we got, PID models. That's it. So using this, what we did is we just generated the heat treatment, okay, and then we did that. So I'll just briefly sketch that what we did. So we have done that, and this software is already available in the market, okay. Okay, here. Yeah, so this is the entire thing. So we have the model which we developed, okay, and then we did. So here, what is the thing we need to do is we got to do some topological things. What we need to do is this is not a regular structure like a square or a sphere. This is a topological structure, okay. So it is very complicated. And again, here you got a topological structure. Now I will pose a simple problem. If it is a usually I want to interactive session, but this may not happen here. Usually I used to pose this question, okay. The thing is that you got three different domain. Before the treatment, the patient will be in one location. During the treatment, he will be in another location, and after the treatment, he will be in another location. Now the question is: since these three are in three different configuration, can we bring them into common domain? So in that case, there will be some student used to answer that. So that is a kind of linear transformation you have to do. So using the linear transformation, what we can do is we can just bring these all these things together in a common place. Okay, and then we can just register that so that all the things are matching. Otherwise, what will happen is we got to compare that whether the real is and the real mathematical one and real one is it matching or not. That we got to superimpose so that we will get that whether it is matching or not. Then second thing, how we measure that. So in order to measure that, what we need is we need something like a mathematical tool called I don't know, like how many of you know, if you know like topology, something called Hausdorff distance you might know. So the Hausdorff distance is nothing but two topological surfaces there. From that you can see like what is the distance between one point over that A domain to B domain, that you will find. So between that you can find that. So using that concept, we can just find like what is the distance between these two topological domain. Okay. So using that we can find. And then once again you can use the you got to do like how much volume. You have one volume from the real region and real one, and you have the volumetric comparison also you got to do. For that, what you can use is you can use the cross divergence theorem. Using cross divergence theorem, you can calculate what is the volume. Because here you know only the surface of the domain, and that surface is closed one. So if the surface is closed one, you can use the cross divergence theorem, and using that you can calculate what is the volume of the domain. So using these mathematical tools, you can do, and then we have this simulation section. Okay, I think you got another 8 minutes. Probably I'll just briefly explain the COVID-19 model also. Okay, so as you know, like this COVID situation, okay, there is a model called SIR. Okay, this SIR is this is additional, not with the cancer treatment. Okay, this is completely different model. This also we can model. Okay, so there is something called SIR. So S means suspectable, E means infectious, R means recurrent. See, all are suspect yes. Once the pandemic came, everyone is suspect yes. Okay, so for example, this one you can compare with the murder case. In murder case, what the inspector will see, he will suspect many people. Okay, he will suspect many people, and then he will inspect or interrogate with the people who he suspect. Then he will just remand him. If he find that he is fine, either he will remand or release. Okay, the same way, if you see the rice of sack, where you can see like a bunch of rice is there. So either it will be, so now we assume that we are like a rice. Okay, so either it will be in the rice state, or it will be the cooked state, or it will be the energy will be released. The same way. So what they used to do is they will just partition that. The whole population of the world, they just partition into these three categories in this model, this simple model, SIR model. They partition into three categories. One is called S. Okay, S means suspectable. Okay, all are suspectable in this case. Okay, all are suspectable. The class of individuals who are healthy but can't contract the disease, so all are suspectable. So that is denoted by S. Then infectious. So infectious means those who got the contact with the virus, means they got already the infection. Okay, they got the coronavirus. So that is infectious. Then the third one is called recovered. Okay, R means those who recovered. Recovered here includes that either they are dead or they recovered from the disease. Okay, that is nothing but recovered here, because we are accounting both together here. Recovered means this R model, it is accounting both death as well as the recovered persons. So the total population is N. Then you can divide that population into three categories. So if you take the whole population, either there will be in the suspect mode, or will be in the infectious mode, or will be in the recovered mode. In one of these categories, they will be there. So now what is the thing is that, how much, what is the probability that the suspect people will move to infect people, okay? Beta is nothing but the probability that S is moving from, the person is moving from S to I, okay? So suppose I is contacting with some S, then there is a high chance that the probability will be high, and those people will be moving immediately to the I. So suppose you, some of your relation or some relations are having infectious, and I just had a contact with them, and then immediately I will just move from S to I. Okay, then from there is a probability that you will move from infectious to R also. Okay, definitely will move from alpha. Okay, so there is some probability. So what is the what rate you are going to move? Okay, per day or per time per minute, etc. So those are the things we can do. So this is the thing which they are doing, okay, in the COVID-19. So this is once again the kind of difference indication. Okay, they are just moving from here to that. So you can see that suspectious. So he is moving, these two people are moving from suspectious to infectious since they contacted. And then so what will happen? Then the suspect will increase, infectious will suspect will decrease, infectious will increase. So that means the rate of incidence. So once the person is contacting, what is happening? The rate of change is nothing but minus incidence. So in the suspect yes, what is happening? It is removing. Okay, he is removing. Therefore, it is minus incidence. Okay, minus incidence. That's why I have got minus incidence. Whereas in the infect yes, what will happen? It will be out of there, because he was removed from here, he will be out over there. So what is happening? What is the probability we have to see? So suppose a person is contacting with them. Okay, CN denote the number of contacts per unit time infected contact. So I just contacted with some 10 people or 5 people. Those are all kind of people I'm just contacting. Okay, C denotes the per capita rate that I'm just contacting with that people. Then S by N is the probability that contacts with the susceptible. Then what will happen is we'll get the CN into S by N is nothing but the number of contacts susceptible who will move from S to I. Okay, so that is nothing but this one. Now, suppose beta is nothing but the probability PC, then what I will get is beta is nothing but, so K will be moving from S to I, so I just get that incident as beta into IS, okay, beta into I into S, K is moving from. Now, what will happen? That beta IS, this beta into IS is moving from here to here, okay, beta into IS is moving from here to here. So here in S, it will be ds by dt, it will be minus, whereas in the I, ti by dt, it will be plus. Okay, now for the recovery, once again, there will be some probability alpha. So if I just put alpha per person, I'm just putting, okay. So here you can see that this is S, and And beta is per person I'm taking. So, per infect, yes, I'm just taking. So, beta into yes. So, there are assumptions of n. Similarly, alpha is the probability here. Then he will be moved from here. In Ida sub t, he will be moved from here. Whereas in R, he will be plus. So, Ida sub t is this one. So, this is the SIR model. So, he will be moved from here to here. That is why beta is the probability. So, this is the probability per person in this infect years. So, beta into I, he is contacting with these many people. That's why beta into I into S. So, S people, they are contacting. So, beta into I, S. So, this they are moving from here to here, it is minus. Those many people will be added over here. Therefore, beta into I, S. Now, alpha is the thing that those many people who are recovering, the probability of recovering people from here to here. Okay, that is alpha into I, S. So, per person, this, so into alpha into I. They are moving from here, that is, therefore, this minus. They are moving here, therefore, this plus. And we have to give what is the S0, I0, means what is the initial condition, etc. That's all. I think I have finished on time. If you have any questions, let me know.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Your speech connecting to real world problems to mathematical model is very nice, sir. Your explanation for cancer treatments about standard therapy and bridging therapy, which are converted to mathematical model like clinical model, T-degression, Fourier series, self-care model is very clear, sir. Thank you for your informative session, sir.
Thank you.
Now I request the participants to unmute your audio and ask questions or type your questions in the chat box. Yes, your questions, please.
I think there are some questions in the chat box, I think. Let me try to answer that. So the first question is, what is the difference between mathematical modeling and statistical modeling? So in mathematical modeling, what we have is, like you see, like completely black box, then we try to understand like what is the parameters are there, and we try to simulate some kind of partial differential equation or linear equation or transfer equation. In statistical modeling, also kind of mathematical modeling, we can say, because here what we do is we try to collect some kind of statistical variables, okay? We just use some kind of probability, etc. And then we try to model whether it will predict or not, okay? Means the statistical model is going to give me the fluctuation. What is the fluctuation which is going to happen between them, okay? So that is kind of statistical modeling. And the same person has asked, model generates data or data generates model? Is this right, sir? Okay, so it is actually both way. So in some cases, since it is a black box, this is a cycle. So sometimes we need to we will generate some model. Okay, for that we will have some synthetic data. So that synthetic data, we just use that, which the model can generate. Okay, that is called synthetic data, we used to say. Whereas if you come for the real thing, what will happen is you can use some of the information data, and then you can generate the model also. Okay, so the both ways are possible. Okay, next question. Which element is used to make such needle? Okay, so this is physics question. So I don't know whether I understand your question correctly. So which element you mean, the type of material, I hope. So there are different aluminium alloy and other alloys, actually steel alloys are there. The combinations are there, listed there. Maybe you can just Google Rita Starburst system. There you can get the types of needle, and also you can see the properties of needle. Another question is, by using distribution, what are the properties to understand? So for Gaussian distribution, in this model, what we need to understand is, we need to understand like how much heat it is producing, okay, and what is the mean and variance, etc. We have to understand. So that is the things we have to do. In SIR model, how can we retrieve model? In SIR model, so in SIR model, I hope you mean like how many people are infecting, how many people are suspected, etc. So in that case, if I don't understand your question, you can just ask that again, okay? So for example, today data and yesterday data we have. So from that, what I can do is I can just find what is my beta from that. So Ts by dt is there. So using the simple thing, Ts by dt is nothing but the difference, right? Difference between the delta difference will be there. So I can assume that today is one day and another day is previous day is delta difference. So I can just make the difference, and the delta t is nothing but 1. So from that you can predict what is the data. So you see that they used to predict like what is the target. But this is a simple model, but you can use that for a complicated model with other complicated things to be equal. Okay. Okay, any other questions? How to get the statistical data for any disease? This is an open question actually. You have to hunt for that. So for this disease, you can find it in many websites that are providing the data. But for any disease means either you have to contact WHO or some of the agencies like the government agencies you have to contact. Say the PPT, okay. Yeah, so those are all the questions I have seen from chat box. What software to be used to create mathematical model? For mathematical modeling, you can't mostly use the software. You have to think of it in your way. But there are some software tools are available, which is called, like, you can see OpenModelica. That's one software. Using that, you can try to model and then you can do. And SimLink also you can use because it has different components in MATLAB that also you can use.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Now it's time to propose cutoff times. Good afternoon to all. I deem it
a great pleasure. Sorry, one person has raised his hand. Maybe you can ask. Is it okay? Sekar has raised his hand. Okay, you can proceed.
Now it's
yep.
time to propose cutoff times. Good afternoon to all. I deem it a great privilege to propose cutoff times on this special occasion to all contributed to the one-day national webinar on mathematical modeling for cancer treatment organized by the PG and Research Department of Mathematics jointly with IPAC, the MBT Hindu College, Sridhar Bedu. First of all, I thank God for the successful completion of the program. At the outset, on behalf of the PG and Research Department of Mathematics and IPAC, I sincerely thank Sri M. Challaiya, Honorary Secretary, Sri S. Meenakshi Sundaram, President, Sri B.P. Chidambaram, Treasurer, members Dr. R. Suresh, Sri A.N.S. Shanmugam, and Sri Nalavoy R. Sirimarayappan for giving us permission to organize this program. I would like to thank our distinguished speaker, Dr. Panchacharam Mariyappan. When we invited him for this program, he immediately accepted our invitation and given his concern in spite of his busy schedule. Once again, I thank for making excellent presentations on mathematical modeling for cancer treatment and making this program interesting and meaningful. I would like to thank Dr. A. Subramanian, principal and head of our department for his enthusiastic support. I would like to thank Mr. G. Vethanaswamy, principal in charge, for giving presentation. I thank Dr. K. R. Subramanian, coordinator IPAC, for his guidance and moral support. I thank Dr. P. Ramachandran, convener of this program, for his encouragement. I take his opportunity to extend my thanks to our faculty members, Dr. S. Challaiya, Dr. N. Meena, Dr. K. Das, Dr. K. Murugan, Dr. K. Ali, and Dr. S. Muhammad for their support and coordination. I thank the principals, head, faculty members, research scholars, and students from various universities and colleges for their participation and involvement during the entire program. I thank our research scholars and students for active participation in this program. I thank Mr. Subhash Chandra Bose, Assistant Professor of Physics, for the technical support, one and all. With these warm words, we move to the end of this program. The feedback is posted in the chat box. We he refused the participants to submit it before 2 p.m. The program ends now. Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Respected organizers, please share the PPT.
நெஞ்சிச்சா உங்களுக்கு சரி இல்லைங்க
அதை அவன் பண்ண தெரியாம தான் பார்த்துட்டு இருக்கேன்